No, my BMW is coming next week, and I had to interview garages.
Smith Barney's an excellent firm. Our rate of arrest is the lowest on the street.
Then we went to this new club called Inside Out. It's kind of like the reverse of Nell's. The bouncers let everybody in, but then they stand on a big table, point to people, and you have to leave. We loved it.
So nice of you to invite me. It's too bad Charlotte couldn't make it.
Poor Charlotte, and her grandfather's dead.
Isn't that awful? An escalator.
Well, let's not talk about that. We're having pasta. Now, where is it that you're from, Lori?
Santa Fe.
Santa, I knew that. Wait, Charlotte said that you have the funniest story. Something about a Winnebago.
A Winnebago.
Margaritas? Is that right? Would you tell us?
No, I couldn't.
You
no,
must. I Please, Charlotte really called from the funeral home to remind me to ask
no,
you.
No, I...
Yes, Lori, you're going to... Everyone, you! Lori has a story. Charlotte says it's the funniest thing she's ever heard. Please.
Well, a group of us were going to celebrate the birthday of a friend of ours, Randy Bailey. And I was going to meet Randy and his wife, Becky, at the Pink Adobe, this restaurant in Santa Fe. And then the three of us were going to drive to the Bailey family ranch in this Winnebago.
Winnebago.
So, but I was late getting to the restaurant. So when I saw them, Randy stood up, nearly knocked the table over. So it was clear that the birthday boy had gotten into the Pink Adobe margaritas.
Winnebago,
and,
margaritas,
and
okay.
Pink Adobe margaritas are not ordinary margaritas. They are deep dish margaritas. And Randy's not a drinker.
No, wait a minute. I was in the Pink Adobe once, and do you know who was at the table next to ours? Andy Warhol.
When was this?
1979.
Oh, God, this was before he died.
So Randy was a boy who needed some food in him if he was going to drive that Winnebago. Mm-hmm. But when the waiter came, Randy said, oh, nothing for me, thanks. Just bring me another margarita. Oh. So you could say he was setting himself up. Oh.
Oh, go ahead.
Yeah.
No, I'll wait.
Please, Lori, go ahead.
Oh, okay. So after dinner, after dinner, I said to Becky.
Please don't let that get cold.
After dinner, I said to Becky, do you think Randy can drive the Winnebago like this? And was I sorry I said that?
Leslie, this is a fabulous pasta. Oh,
yes, it is. So Becky said that no, Randy couldn't drive the Winnebago like that, and she couldn't either. So I said, forget the Winnebago, we'll take my car. Well, when we got to my car, I had forgotten to put the top up. And it had been raining. I forgot to say that it had been raining.
Oh, that'll be Adam. Mary, will you get that, please? Lori, go ahead.
Well,
please pass the wine. And Phyllis, will you turn the music up just a tiny, tiny bit?
So I was going to have to drive this huge Winnebago. I mean, the key to the
day. I know. Sorry I'm late. Sorry.
Lori, go ahead.
So, did you drive that big Winnebago?
Down the mountain, I am careening around a bend, and frozen in front of me is an old mountain dog. So I turn around to yell for Randy, and he's asleep on the floor.
Oh.
And I said to myself, the dog dies.
Goodness, is he all right?
He's choking.
Choking? Gordon, tell your choking story.
The one at the White House, that one?
Yes, yeah, Charlotte says it's side-splitting. You love it.
I'm seated between Corazon Aquino and Barbara Sinatra enjoying my pepper steak.
Pepper steak, okay.
When suddenly a very red-faced man comes up.